Linux market share on Steam has just passed over the 3% mark. Far less interesting is macOS is now back over 2%. And 3% is not massive in the grand scheme of things, right? Because Windows is still the majority of the market share. But things are trending upwards, and they're trending upwards at a fairly fast pace. Do I think we're ever going to be at 10% or 15% or 20%? I do think 10% is possible, and I would love to see it go higher, but frankly, I am just happy that things are moving in a good direction. And there's no way to know what the numbers are like on GOG, Epic, various other stores out there, games that happen to have their own launches, but I would be surprised if they're not also trending in the same direction. Are they at the same number? I have no idea, but I think the direction is going, you know, somewhat upwards. And recently, you may have seen articles like this floating around. Nearly 90% of Windows games now run on Linux, latest data shows. As Windows 10 dies, gaming on Linux is more viable than ever. You don't need the title to be that long, firstly. This part here is already mostly true, but there are some footnotes, there are some asterisks. This is not entirely accurate. Now, the data it's based on isn't wrong. The way people are interpreting the data, on the other hand, it's not fully correct. And if you're not aware of how gaming on Linux actually works, the word run is doing a lot of heavy lifting. So the numbers that are being talked about here are being pulled from a site known as Boiling Steam. They wrote this article, Windows games compatibility on Linux is at an all-time high. And that is an accurate title. But Boiling Steam didn't come up with the metrics themselves. Instead, they're based on a site known as ProtonDB. And if you're a Linux gamer, you know exactly what this site is. This is the premier location to go to know if a game is going to function. And there's nothing wrong with this piece itself. It is clear on what is actually being talked about. But a lot of people who looked at the charts, looked at what was written here, are not Linux people and don't actually understand what is being talked about in this article. When we talk about gaming on Linux, there are two main categories we are looking at. One are the native games, and then two are the Windows games through a compatibility layer. So a native game is a game that was released and built specifically to run on Linux, like you would have the PS5 version of a game, or the Xbox version of the game, or when you have a PC release, the Windows version of a game, or the macOS version of a game. There are also Linux versions of a game. Hollow Knight, for example, has a Linux native version, and this is a few percent of the Steam library. However, when we're talking about the ProtonDB medal system, which is what this is based on, we have platinum, gold, silver, bronze, and borked. It might be a little small, but that is what it says. There is a separate badge for native, and that is not included in that listing. Now, sometimes things are a bit funky because there are games like Hollow Knight and like Silksong, which the Windows version of the game has a platinum rating, but it is also a native game. So the Linux version is the Linux version, and the Windows version is marked as working perfectly. There are other games where there is a Linux version, and then the Windows version doesn't run whatsoever. So the numbers are a little bit finicky because of that. It's not terrible. It only affects it by like maybe 0.5% or 1%, but it is worth noting. And the other games are those Windows games through a compatibility layer. So this is for the most part going to be Wine, which is Wine is not an emulator. Don't question the name. It's basically a way to take things that run on Windows and then convert them into things that run on Linux. It's basically just doing all of that stuff as you are running the EXE. And if you're running a game on Steam, you're probably going to be using Proton. That's where the Proton part of ProtonDB comes from. Proton is wine, along with a collection of various other things to make specifically games work better. And with that out of the way, there are two main ways to rank how well a game works on Linux as well. There is the DEC verified system and the ProtonDB metal system. Now, technically, ProtonDB has other rankings as well, but the metal system is the one that most people know, most people use, and has been around the longest. So DEC Verified is a system run directly by Valve. They will do internal testing of a game, they'll mark how well the game works on the Steam Deck, things that need to be fixed to make it work better, things like that. If you've ever seen a game marked as DEC Verified or DEC Playable or Unsupported or Unknown, specifically within Steam, especially on the Steam Deck, that is what that rating is. Game developers can encourage this rating as well, they can help do testing, they can go and fix things, and all this good stuff, but the system, for the most part, is run by Valve. The ProtonDB metal system, on the other hand, this is entirely community-driven. So a game like Hollow Knight, this has a platinum rating. This basically means you run the game, it runs perfectly. There are no problems whatsoever. Any problems that exist in the game also exist over on the Windows version as well. Then we have a game that is gold rated. This might have a couple of little problems here and there, but for the most part, it works perfectly fine. Let's see if we can find, yeah, here we go, a bronze rated game. This is a game that crashes often, you're gonna have to do some fixes and change some settings, but it's playable, it's not a pleasant experience. I would say avoid any games marked lower than silver. Silver is, you might find some issues with it, you might find that you have to tweak some stuff, but it works for the most part. A game marked as balked either won't start or is crucially unplayable. So if you have a, you know, AAA shooter and the multiplayer doesn't work, in many cases, that's just going to be marked as balked. On many occasions, I have critiqued the DEC verified system because in a lot of cases, it's outdated, it's not actually accurate, it specifically only applies to the Steam Deck, and in some cases, it's not even accurate on the Steam Deck. I think the community-driven method on ProtonDB is vastly more accurate, and I do wish they would do some sort of collaboration and bring this data directly into Steam. And this data, the ProtonDB data, this is what the Boiling Steam article is based on. So for this chart, it has both balked and bronze in red. The bronze is more orangey, but it's still counted as red. 90% of games are silver or higher, so silver, gold, or platinum. 90% of games basically just work. Keep in mind when a game is marked as silver, it might require different versions of Proton, it might require some tinkering, it might require setting some environment variables, but for the most part, 90% of games work on Steam. And that's the other part that's not being talked about. And there are some weird other exceptions, but for the most part, the games that don't work are anti-cheat games. So there are a lot of these titles, obviously Fortnite isn't on Steam, but a lot of these other games are, where they just are not going to work. Where they have denied support, where maybe they're going to do it in the future, but haven't done it so far, or maybe they had it working and then they broke it. For the most part, the games that are marked as balked are gonna be in that category. There aren't really any games outside of that which are completely broken. There are some, but for the most part. When it comes to the games in bronze, there are some older titles which have like weird video codecs and the cutscenes don't play, and maybe the game is very cutscene heavy, so it's basically unusable because of that. There have also been games like Persona 5 Strikers, where when the game came out, it just didn't open. For some reason, the DRM wasn't working on Linux, and this also caused a problem where when people were testing to try to fix the DRM, it would temporarily ban them from the game because they did too many logins, and when you change versions of Proton, apparently those are counted as different systems. So those games are rare, but they do exist as well. So because of the whole thing with anti-cheat games and a lot of the biggest games on Steam being, you know, these big shooters, it might be 90% of games, but it's not 90% of players. Just keep that in mind. Also, the 90% itself is kind of misleading. This chart is based on ProtonDB numbers. And the chart itself, this article is honest about it. But a lot of the other articles are framing it as 90% of games. This isn't 90% of games, it's 90% of games on Steam. I would very much like ProtonDB to track other games, but ProtonDB is specifically just about games on Steam. So, any games that are only available on GOG, a lot of older games that, for example, are not being sold anywhere else, the massive market of games on itch.io, Epic Games, let alone all of the games that have their own launcher or games that are just not on sale anywhere whatsoever, in many cases, these games are going to function. In many cases, it's going to be fine. But they're not being tracked by these numbers. So it is kind of misleading to say 90% of Windows games when it's just 90% of games on Steam. Things exist outside of Steam. It's just the main platform nowadays. And honestly, I would kind of argue, at least from my experience, that by focusing on the Steam numbers, it probably undershoots the number of games that actually do work. The majority of things on itch.io, I don't see how there would be a problem. The majority of older games, except the ones using weird codecs for cutscenes, probably work really well as well. And a lot of the games on the Epic Store or GOG, outside of the ones that might have anti-cheat, are probably fine as well. So it's hard to say what the number would actually be, but it's probably higher than the 90% being suggested. Now, as a personal anecdote, I don't really look at whether or not a game is going to work on Linux anymore. Yes, ProtonDB is an incredible resource, but if I want to go and just play something, I'll usually just download it or buy it, depending on what the game is, and for the majority of games that I play, they just work. This is basically one of the only multiplayer games I play, the other being Marvel Rivals, which also works really well on Linux. But we're talking about, you know, random single-player JRPGs. You know, there's no issues whatsoever. I've had some games where random cutscenes don't play. I've had issues with, like, desynced audio in a cutscene, but that's, like, one out of 30 games probably, and the problem's probably dealt with by now. So for me, I can just buy it and I don't have to think about it. And that's a good state to be in. That's a really good state because people who are playing a game probably just want to relax. They don't want to deal with problems. They don't want to deal with troubleshooting things. They're playing a game because they don't want to deal with anything. And whilst there are these big multiplayer games that are a problem, and I would like them to not be a problem, if you're the kind of person that plays games like I do, mostly single-player titles, maybe some co-op things here and there, the idea that you can't game on Linux at this point is completely inaccurate. Welcome to dark mode. Let me know your Linux gaming experience down below. The whole idea of this 90%, it makes sense why people are talking about it, but the number's not entirely accurate. However, Linux gaming is in a really good state, so do you play games on your system? Do you not? I would love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video, go subscribe as well, and if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon Subscribe Stanley Barapay linked in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me, and yes, this is how I dress when it's cold. It's comfy.